Like clockwork, the cows come in, and the milking begins. In the low-ceiling parlor at Cozy Nook Farm in Waukesha, Tom Oberhaus, his wife, and one employee milk 72 cows, morning and night, a job that never gets a day off.
This doesn't look like much here, but when the cows come up this 12-inch step, the udder's right here, you got the seat to sit on.
In the century-old barn, there's little technology.
So this is the milking unit that attaches to the cow. A good example of 20-year-old technology that's really pretty economical, but it gives us a measurement on the milk. It also records the temperature of the milk.
Oberhaus says they choose to keep their farm hands-on.
Financially, I'm in better shape doing it this way right now than making the big-time investment.
An investment that's changing the game for other dairy farms. Statewide, there are about 9,500 dairy farms. 90% of the milk is used for cheese. According to the USDA, Wisconsin is the number one cheese producer in the country, making 3 billion pounds of cheese a year. So the demand is there, but we learned the labor pool isn't.
In that old barn over there, the Fieldstone barn, we milked cows basically manually in a stanchion barn twice a day with a pipeline.
At Stonehouse Dairy in Hartford, 23-year-old dairy farmer Jake Gehring is sixth generation. He's making a move now he hopes will save the family farm and business.
So we went to the robotics that they show up. They're here all the time. They never leave the barn. It's always running. Out here is actually where the milking takes place.
2 years of research, $2 million, and two robotic milkers are on the job. Now four cows can get milked at once, up to five times a day, totally by themselves.
There's a little more than 180 cows in here. It's what's known as a free-flow system. They're on their own, roaming as they please, but when it's time to milk, they know what to do and go right for the robot.
Stonehouse is the first in Washington County and among only a handful in Wisconsin to use these robots. Jake says udder pressure and food motivate the cows to get milked.
Feeding part of the nutrients that they need in the feed lane and the other part in the robot, so they're coming to get their complete diet in the robot.
Once inside, the robot goes to work.
It does an actual 3D image, so it knows where our udder is. Now a 2D camera is going to come behind, recognize the teat, the laser is going to scan it, confirm it's a teat, and then it makes the attachment.
Everything is monitored by computer. The cows even wear a sort of Fitbit that tracks their activity.
We are able to do all the operations of the farm with two full-time, I'm part-time.
Fewer laborers and more milk to this family seems like a win-win. They call it the future of dairy farming. In Hartford, Hillary Mintz, WISN 12 News.
A few Wisconsin farmers have been using the technology since 2014. It's also being used in other states like New York, Minnesota, Ohio, and Maryland. Also in Europe, where many of the machines are made.